Hi, I am K. Sumathi, working as Assistant Professor in EC Department at SNS College of Technology. Dear students, today going to discuss about case study on Reliance CDMA cellular phone. Reliance CDMA cellular phone gained much popularity over a period of time and later it vanished all of a sudden. So, in this case study, we will discuss what is CDMA phone, its advantages and drawbacks, and how GSM phone take over CDMA. Let's go into the case study now. What is CDMA? So CDMA means code division multiple access. The code division multiple access is a channel access method used by various radio communication technologies. CDMA is an example of multiple access where several transmitters can send information simultaneously over a single communication channel. So this allows several users to share a band of frequencies. So that is called co-divisional multiple access. Why CDMA is needed in communication? So CDMA is a spread spectrum technique where the multiple users to access the system at the same example in a cell and of course on the same frequency. It spreads information using codes that are unique to the mobile station in all the CDMA cellular system. So CDMA is needed in communication. Then the architecture, general architecture of co-divisional multiple access consists of mobile station, base station subsystems and network subsystems. The base station subsystem consists of the port of the base station and base station controller, and the network subsystem consists of HLR, that means home location register, and VLR, visitors location register, and authentication center, equipment identity register. Mainly it consists of mobile switch center, that means mobile switching center. So the informations are transferred from mobile station to public switch telephone network with the help of mobile station subsystems and the network subsystems. The main advantages of the CDMA technologies is adopted of many of these 3G cellular telecommunication systems. The CDMA technology in mobile communications possesses so many advantages. So the advantages are improvement in capacity and security, and improvement in handover and handoff. So the improvement in capacity and security, one of the chief claims of CDMA is that it gives significant improvements in network capacity. In CDMA technology, data and voice packets are separated using codes and then transmitted by using a wide range of frequencies. Because more space is allocated for data in CDMA, this standard has become attractive for 3G high-speed mobile internet use. The another advantage is improvement in handover and handoff. By using CDMA technology, it is easy for terminal to communicate with two base stations at once. In case of this, old link is to be broken when the new one is established. This provides improvement in terms of the reliability of handover or handoff from one base station to the another base station. CDMA technology has been used in 3G telecommunication systems in one form to the another. CDMA has become successful in every aspect and it has enabled improvements need to be gained over the previous technologies used in 2G systems. So these are the main advantages of the co-division multiple access, and some disadvantages of CDMA is the time synchronization is required, is the main disadvantage of CDMA, and it cannot offer international roaming a long GSM advantage. The CDMA system performance degrades with an increase in the number of users. This is main disadvantage of co-divisional multiple access. Then a network of CDMA is not matched because it is relatively new with GSM. So these are the main disadvantages of co-divisional multiple access. then applications of the CDMA is due to inherent advantages of CDMA over TDMA and FDMA. TDMA means time division multiple access and frequency division multiple access, such as user capacity, soft hands, offs and security, etc. CDMA emerges as a winner in the battle of wireless technology and services. It for greater development and the use of broadband devices such as wireless laptops, modems, GPS systems, units and other innovative devices. And then another application is for business purposes. CDMA supports in providing high speed push to talk and push to email services. Push to talk gives mobile an ability to be used as a walkie talkie device. These services are exempted from the service charges imposed by the operators, making CDMA cost effective. Then it is considered as the highest mode of wireless communications and is responsible for giving fast and safe mode of data exchange such as 3G. Recently, CDMA has merged with the GSM technology to give a high-speed 4G internet services. The GSM and CDMA are two dominant technologies in mobile communications. These technologies differ in the way both calls and data travel over a mobile network. When we compare both technologies, this GSM technology has some limitations as far as the quality is concerned. Still, it is more flexible compared to the CDMA technology. The difference between GSM and CDMA can be considered in terms of technology they use, the security factors and the data transfer speeds and so on. In 2008, it entered the GSM space. The bulk of its users' space belonged to CDMA space. The low-priced mobile services were offered using the CDMA backbone that was closed in 2016. It appears that only a small percentage of their initial CDMA customers continued with them in their GSM journey. Also, the move from CDMA to GSM would have resulted in significant investments in the infrastructure and getting rid of legacy CDMA infra. Moving to GSM, they lost the price advantage of CDMA, brought them on the same platform and delivery pricing model as their competitors. Since then, Reliance Communications has failed to innovate itself and hence failed to attract new customers.